Okay, so what are we doing now?
So we're making vanilla rum panna cotta with salted caramel on top. Does that sound good?
Sounds
fantastic. Panna cotta is one of those things that people think are too scary to make, and it's so easy to do. It's incredible.
Because it looks very fancy.
It does, but it's all in the way you present it. So the first thing I need is gelatin. And what I've done is I've got 3 tablespoons of cold water, and you need to soften gelatin in cold water. This is 2 teaspoons or 1 packet. And just sprinkle it on, and then just stir it in.
So that's just powdered Jell-O?
Just powdered gelatin. It's unflavored powdered gelatin. You don't want to use lime Jell-O here. So this is just going to soften, and then I'm going to put it in hot liquid, and it dissolves it. So I'm just going to put this aside. Okay, the next thing is cream. Can't make panna cotta without cream, sorry to say.
Panna cotta is, where does it come from?
It's Italian. It's cooked cream, literally. And that's kind of what it is. So it's 1.5 cups of cream. Do you know the difference between wet measures and dry measures and how you measure them?
I know I'm supposed to, but I don't.
So wet measure is like a measuring cup where you see the line. Mm-hmm. So you fill it up to the line, you can see it. But a dry measure is something where you do it like this and you can level it off. And it's about getting precise measures.
Well, I don't understand the difference there.
So wet measures, you pour. So 1.5 cups of cream goes into this up to the line of 1.5.
Right.
But a dry measure is something where you can just level it off, like yogurt. I know it's not actually dry, but you level it off. Do you want to get me a knife?
Mm-hmm.
So right there, so I can level it off. I need 2 cups of yogurt. So this is more precise because you can level it off just like that.
I see.
So that's 2 cups of yogurt. So it's not all bad. It's got yogurt in it, right?
Right.
Okay. So, and I'm just gonna measure this out. This is whole milk yogurt, plain yogurt, no flavors. Okay, I'm a very messy cook, I hope you understand.
Isn't that part of the job requirement?
I think it's important. I think messy cooks are creative cooks, right?
Yes.
Okay, the next thing I need is vanilla, 2 teaspoons of vanilla. And this is really good vanilla extract. I love the way it smells. Mm. Isn't that great? This is the time when pure vanilla extract makes all the difference in the world because, you know, like artificial ingredients just taste like chemicals. And the next thing, in order for something, just like the fish where you could see the mustard seeds, I want the flavor and I want you to be able to see the vanilla beans. That's what this is. I make my own vanilla and vanilla beans. And this jar has been going for like 35 years. It just sits in the pantry. It's vanilla beans and vodka. And if you have a dry vanilla bean, you can cut it in half and then scrape the seeds out.
I mean, this looks like something out of a swamp in Louisiana, quite honestly.
Oh, but it smells better than that, doesn't it? Isn't that amazing?
Gosh. So that's just clear vodka goes in there
just
with
clear
the vanilla
vodka
beans.
And vanilla beans, and they soak. And in a few months, they get soft. You end up with vanilla and the beans. And look what happens. You can just squeeze the seeds out.
Like
that. And you have all of the flavor of the vanilla bean right there.
So that's
amazing?
The seeds that just dissolve inside the pod?
Yeah, it just softens inside the pot. But if you don't have that, you can always just cut it open and scrape out the vanilla seeds.
Is that what vanilla is? It's just vanilla
beans and vodka.
Really?
That's exactly what it is. I don't know, maybe a vanilla manufacturer would disagree with me, but I think that's what it is. So I'm just going to whisk this together. And now what I've done is I've heated up. Cream. 1.5 cups of cream. And 3/4 of a cup of sugar, just until the sugar dissolves. And I'm gonna take the softened gelatin and just put it in, and that's gonna dissolve it. And it's the gelatin that really makes this dish.
It binds it all together.
Yeah, that makes it firm. Thank you.
Sure.
You're a very good sous chef.
For these free lessons, I'll do anything.
So I'm just gonna stir this until the gelatin dissolves, and then pour it into this. And you can't make vanilla rum panna cotta without rum. So this was
cream and sugar.
Cream and sugar, just
with a little gelatin.
Just heat it up just so the sugar dissolves. And then I put the gelatin and that we softened into it. And then I'm just gonna pour this right into, as soon as it dissolves, just pour it right into this mixture. And panna cotta is literally this easy. Isn't that incredible? Just like that. And one of the tricks, I think, sort of cook like a pro tricks is to take something really simple like panna cotta and, thank you, you can just put it on that. Great. And just serve it in a really pretty glass, something a little special. So I'm gonna put in 3 tablespoons of rum. I like sort of dark rum.
Milk is my favorite.
Isn't that the best?
Yeah.
It's just fabulous.
Milk and tonic with a little lime.
Mmm. That'll be after the panna cotta, right? So 3 tablespoons. And literally, that's it. That's panna cotta. That's pretty easy.
That's it.
Isn't it? That's it. And so it looks daunting, but it's really not. So the nice thing about this is you have to make it the day before because you put it in the refrigerator and it sets. So when you're ready to serve dessert, it's all ready.
Again, this is, I don't know how long you took here, but
not very long,
seven,
right?
8 minutes.
And not stressful. So the trick is, now what I want to do is I want to put it in these pretty glasses. These are just drinking glasses. Just gonna put it in these glasses. Now how do you get that into that without getting it all over the place? And what I do is I put it in a measuring cup with a spout. So, I mean, it's something everybody has in their kitchen is a measuring cup, but it's so much easier to do this way.
Rather than get it all over the kitchen.
Exactly, and all over the glasses. So you don't want it pouring down the sides of the glasses. So you just pour it in like this. This will make like 6 to 8 panna cottas. And then afterwards, after it sets, what we're gonna do is put caramel sauce on the top and salt. And that salt is that edge that I'm always looking for, you know, that gives it a lot of flavor.
Because this is going to be very, very rich just by itself.
Yeah. Well, it is dessert. Okay, I'm just going to finish this. And luckily, I have one already set in the fridge. So we can do the salted caramel part.
Oh, great. So it just refrigerates for...
Overnight. Well, maybe 8 hours or overnight, yeah.
I don't know if I've ever had panna cotta.
Oh, you haven't? Oh, are you in for a treat? It's just one of those elegant nursery desserts.
Elegant nursery?
You know, it's like nursery desserts, like things that you remember from your childhood.
Oh, yeah.
But it's elevated to a higher level.
I've never heard that term.
So this goes in the fridge. If you can open the fridge, and I have some already done. So that's panna cotta that we made yesterday. Okay, now for the topping. So what I do is I take caramel, which you
can buy. So this is just a jar of caramel sauce.
It's a jar of caramel sauce. Find really good caramel sauce. I use Fran's, which is fantastic. And I'm just gonna put it in a pan. You just want it warm, slightly warm, so you can pour it on top of the panna cotta. And I'm gonna put a little splash
of course.
Rum in it, of course, because it always makes everything better. And you don't want to do that with the flame on, so try and do it before. Otherwise, you end up...
Now, I noticed that wasn't a proper measure. See, that's what
yeah,
I imagine you're
right.
doing.
Is that I didn't.
You know it in your heart.
Well,
and so
I might, but I still am very specific. This one I happen to know. So, and you can always add a little more caramel, a little more rum. So I'm just going to heat this up and then just do a little layer on the top. So what you get is the warm caramel, the salt, and then the cold panna cotta underneath it. And the textures and the flavors are just incredibly good together. And the best thing is you can make it a day in advance. Ready to go?
Yeah.
Okay, we're ready to put the topping on. So this is just really simple caramel sauce. I'm just going to put a drizzle of caramel on each one. Just like that. So you get the cold panna cotta,
such
the warm
a beautiful
caramel.
White brown.
Yeah, it's pretty, isn't it? Yeah. And do you want to put a little sprinkle of fleur de sel? So fleur de sel is really sort of like sea salt, and it's just a pinch on the top.
All over?
I usually put it right in the middle, but you can do it all over. Isn't that great? Look at that. And who wouldn't want to have this for dessert? Why do I think this is the next thing your son's going to be making for you?
Let's hope so.
Just a little bit on each one. This is a great resource. I'll switch with you. That's the panna cotta do-si-do. And you are going to taste one of these, right?
Oh, yeah. That's the whole point, right?
That's the whole point. Okay, sea salt on each one. 2 spoons.
And you serve it this way, hot on top, cold on the bottom.
That's the way I like it.
Thanks.
Gentlemen, start your engines.
Cheers.
Cheers. That's salted caramel panna cotta. And it's your first
so
panna cotta?
Beautiful. It is.
Wow.
That
and
is
and you're wearing,
really,
you're
really rich.
Bathing it. It's really rich. Is it really good too?
Oh my gosh.
You can really taste all the layers. You can taste the vanilla and you can taste the rum.
Wow.
Thank you.
Now I don't have to put this down, right?
No, you can keep it.
That's really fantastic.
Thank you. I'm so glad you like it. Mm. I don't think anybody's getting this glass away from you until it's gone.
My cold, dead hands. Boy, that's really good.
Thank you. Well, you can come sous chef with me anytime.
It's a deal.
That's great.
Thank you.
You're welcome.